everyone. Today we're going to be doing some low back stretches. Now, if you do have low back pain, I'd highly suggest that you look at our hip stretching program as well, all right? Because the big muscles around our hips influence our low back, and our low back influence our hips. So you shouldn't just be doing low back stretches. If you do have pain, you should be looking at doing both of them. So the first stretch we're going to do is for our QL muscles, which are really big, thick muscles right at the lower base of our back, all right, right down through here. So what we're going to be doing with this is we're actually going to start by kneeling, and we're going to stretch our right side of our low back first. We're going to kneel, but we're going to drop our right butt cheek off of our heels. Then we're going to take this arm and we're going to pull it almost like you're pulling it out of its socket, and you're going to reach over at an angle and hold it there. Now let me just show you what it looks like from the side. All right, so again, I'm kneeling, I'm dropping that right butt cheek off, and I'm reaching over to the side. So to actually hold this stretch, okay, again, drop your right butt cheek, pull this arm out of its socket, and hold here. Low back stretches are really important, that while we're holding them, to have some really deep, big breaths, because we want to get our ribs moving as well while we're stretching. The other side, you're going to drop your butt off that side, pull this hand, and stretch into the corner. And that's a QL stretch. All right, the next stretch we're going to do for our low back is just a kneeling side flexion. So what we're going to do is we're going to reach up as high as we can, and we're going to pull again our right arm. We're going to lean over to the left side. So we're going to pull it up as high as we can, and then lean over to the side. Now it's really important to be pulling this arm up and over. And as you can see, as I lean over to the side, my hips kind of shift over as well. So while we're here, again, nice deep breaths to get our ribs moving. Up to the other side. You might need to, again, lean a little bit forwards, lean a bit backwards, twist wherever you feel that best stretch. You should be feeling a stretch all the way down the side of your back. Right, the next stretch we're gonna do is a child's pose stretch, okay? So we're going to be kneeling, we're gonna separate our legs a little bit, and we're gonna reach as far in front as we can. Once we're there, the stretch is actually when we're going to be when we go to the side. So starting with our right hand, we're going to reach over to the corner, and you're going to plant your hand and then reach away from it. So you should be feeling the stretch down the side of your back, okay? And we're going to hold for 5 deep breaths. Child's pose, and then we're going to reach over with our left and hold it there. Another really good stretch for your low back is being in a sitting V position. Now, it's a little bit tricky, this one, but what you want to do is take your hand, your right hand, over to your left leg. So you're going to twist your body a little bit, and then you're going to reach over top of your body. You should really be able to feel a stretch down through your back this way. So again, sitting, twist first, then arm up and over. And again, really be stretching this arm out and trying to get as far over to that leg as possible. Here, hold 5 deep breaths. Right, the next stretch we're gonna do is gonna bring into some rotation of our low back. Right, so we're gonna lay on our back. We're gonna bring one leg up and cross it over. And we're gonna put our top, our left hand over top of that knee to try to push it down a little bit. Our other hand is extended as far over as possible, and we're actually gonna look towards it and pull our body apart that way. Show you from a different angle. Another way to get a bit more extension, especially through our lower back, because we've been sitting rounded a lot, all right, is something I call road kills. So it's like an up dog, but with our leg out to the side. So we're going to get back down to the position. We're gonna bring one leg up. From here, we're gonna be pushing up. You're gonna feel maybe a stretch on this side, but what's important is we're actually getting some compression through that part of our back. And gets our body used to being an extension, and side bending is what's happening. All right, same thing on this side, pushing up and down. I'll show you from the side view what that looks like. You're gonna put one leg up and push up and down. For this exercise, you can be doing it multiple times, or you can get up into that position, hold it, and breathe. All right, the next stretch we're gonna do is more of a movement-based stretch. When I stand up, I'm gonna cut my head off, but that's okay. What we're gonna practice is we're gonna pretend like we're in a glass box. So we have glass down the sides of us, we have glass in front of us. And when we're moving, we wanna make a fingerprint on every single part of that glass. The point of this exercise is to really move and stretch in every single direction for our body. So what it's gonna look like, and it might look a little funny, that's fine, is we're gonna stand up, plant our feet, and we're gonna stretch and touch every single part of our glass. Now we might twist, we might reach up there, we might reach out with two, we might reach out with two there, one, don't forget the back wall. Just moving and touching every single piece of glass, and we're gonna make a big movements. You might need to reach backwards. With this exercise, don't be scared of getting into a weird position, all right? You're gonna do it controlled, and we want our bodies and our spine to be able to move in every single direction possible, so when we get back to sport, we can move quickly and be agile.